Oh, hi, my name's Susanne Gervay and I'm an author, a writer, but I especially love to write kids' books. I'd really like to thank the Sydney Mechanics of Art School and Thomas Keneally Library for actually loving books and for doing this video clip, because books matter. You know, libraries matter, and they're the oldest library in Australia. If you ever want to visit them, go to Pitt Street. I have, and I love them. Well, I'm going to tell you my journey as an author. I'm an author because I have had a traumatic life. Yes, most authors tell the truth, if they're any good. And my parents were refugees from war and just terrible times, and they were given the gift of coming to this country. It was a really hard gift because they had democracy, which they loved, but they didn't speak English. They spoke Hungarian, and that was pretty hard. My mother's father was a professor of engineering, but she ended up working in a clothing factory. And my father had been a farmer for decades, generations, and he ended up working in the car factory. But they were grateful every day to be in this country because they could rebuild. And the thing that gave me strength as the child of refugees was books. I read books all the time, and I started to write, and I wrote the truth. My beautiful father, when he died, my heart was broken and I couldn't recover until I started to write about him. He's in all my books. He's the granddad in I Am Jack. He's the grandfather in The Cave. He's the father in my picture books, Ships in the Field. My father permeates my books. He comes in different forms, but it's his values. The values of loving family, having courage, meeting any challenge. One of my most loved books is the I Am Jack book. See, that's my son. He's got spiky hair, and hundreds of thousands of children have rubbed the top of his head, which is why his hair is less spiky. And I wrote I Am Jack, and the whole series, there's four books. I wrote it because my beautiful son was bullied at school. He couldn't tell jokes anymore. He couldn't be the amazing boy he always was. And he didn't tell me because kids are brave. He's brave. He didn't want to upset me when I worked so hard. I love kids, but I found out when his friend's parent rang me. And what I did was what every parent should do. I ran to the school and I told them that my son was in trouble, and he begged me not to, but forget it. I would stand up for my son. And do you know what? He won against bullying with the support of me, his beautiful school, the librarian and books. He won with his friends who had left him, and he became I Am Jack again. And that became the basis of my books. This book is sold hundreds of thousands of books. It's in every school, well, nearly. And it empowers kids to know when they're in trouble, they'll have a friend, Jack. I invite them into my home. But I've written lots of books, all the way from picture books to young adult. But I'm going to talk about a book that will be coming out in May. And one that is deep to my heart. It's called Elephants Have Wings. I went to India. I travel all over the world speaking to kids and parents. And when I was in India, I saw great poverty, but I also saw great beauty. I'm going to show you something special. Hold your breath. Is this amazing? I captured the spirituality of Asia and India, and I translated it into a book that kids can engage in, think, and find their own pathways to peace on the wings of a beautiful elephant. And if you look at this beautiful picture, there's the tree of life, the tree that makes us all one person. There's the beautiful elephant. The elephant is representative of Ganesh, the Hindu god, and Buddha was reincarnated as an elephant. And Islam, Muhammad was born in the year of elephant. And what is more important, we as a humanity must protect elephants because they are part of God's creatures. There he is meditating with two beautiful children. And if kids are looking carefully, they'll count the many elephants. They'll see the spiritual red. This book took me a long time to write, even though it's a picture book. Took me a long time to write because I had to think about how we are all different but the same. It's inspired by the parable of the blind men and the elephant, that we believe we're right and we're holding different parts of the elephant. And when we stand back, we're holding one elephant. There are many pathways to goodness, many pathways to peace. And this is a book that encourages young people to talk with their parents and adults and find their own pathway. And I'm going to end on this note, the very end of the book. It says that kids are finding a secret, and they find the secret. Everyone is different, but we are the same too. The elephant is in all of us, and I leave it for you to find what your elephant is. Thank you so much, and thank you to this wonderful bookshop for supporting this initiative. Thank you, and bye.